What's happening, yo whippersnappers? It's your Glenn and Johnson, and I'm here today to talk with you about some business. Yes, sir. Talking business with Uncle Ed. We're gonna talk about some things that your daddy should have told you, but it's alright. Uncle Ed is here, and we gon' get you straight. On today's episode, we're gonna talk about something important. Alright, a lot of y'all business owners running around don't know who your customer is. I'd be like, hey, who you trying to target? Just who wants your products and services? Talking about everybody. No, they don't. And then I ask them, who do they look like? What do they do? What do they like? They like, oh man, you asking too much. But I know, fool, you don't know enough. Yes, sir. So today we're gonna focus just on that. How we focus on the who. And the who is who you target for your products and services and do your business. Who cares about you? And might be interested in what you got and what you have to offer. Yes, sir, that's what y'all need. And today's episode is just about that. You need an idea of who your customer is. And you do that by creating a customer persona. So tune in to today's episode while we talk about your customer. Your customer persona! A customer is any person or any organization that buys goods and services from a business. And the process of customer discovery is getting to know that customer and understanding how your product provides value to them in a way that it solves a problem or fills a need. The customer discovery process is around identifying exactly who it is that your product delivers value to and understanding all the different ways that your product delivers that value so holistically you can provide the ideal solution for the customer that you're targeting. So a customer persona is essentially a template or a page of data that you use that provides representations of the key traits of the audience that you're trying to target. So customer personas are usually built on profiles of groups of customers. And the good thing about customer personas, because once collected and validated, customer personas allow product developers a really good way of really understanding all of the customers or groups of customers that we are building a product for. And with these customer personas, it provides us with information so that we know who our customer is, we understand how they think, we understand what influences them. So as we're developing our product, we know what changes and improvements to make to target our customers exactly. So your customer persona, it has your demographics field, where you identify the genders and the age and the marital status of your customer, identifying how many children or if they do have children, and how much money they make, and how much education that they have. It identifies what stage of their life that they're in so that you have a full list of demographics helping you better profile and identify and organize the customer segments that you are targeting. Next, customer persona has the location of your particular customer segment. Personas differ based on the location that they're in. The customers that are in, North America are different than the customers that are in China or that are in Europe. So identifying what the geographic location of your customer is very important to help you understand more about who you're targeting. And next, a good customer persona has information about behavior questions. So things about their occupation and their hobbies and their interests so that you can get a deeper feel about who your customer is and what they like and what they don't like. The customer persona together, you know the demographics of your customer, you know how to really get in tune with them, you know the ins and outs of what they like and what they don't like, and the types of things that make them interested in what you have to offer.
So I want you to go out and try this stuff out that you learned in today's video, alright? And when you try it out, reach out to us and let us know how it worked, okay? The more you try it out, the better feedback we get and the more content we can give to y'all, all right?
In our next video, we're gonna take some time to talk more about your business, okay? But until then, like this video, share it, subscribe to
and follow us for more updates. Until the next time we meet, keep holding it down, young players and young player Ronnie. Get your business straight, and if you need help, don't be afraid to call on your Uncle Ed. Peace out. We'll be right back.